Hello and welcome to this video. This is Pam Obasa from The Lucrative Lady. And in this video, I'm going to be walking you through 11 ways to sell on Instagram. I am so incredibly excited about this because I feel like so many people get it wrong. And a lot of people don't actually understand how to use Instagram. And Instagram is one of my favorite platforms. Well, now it is. Before, I didn't really understand how to use it and how to use it to grow my business, how to use it to sell, how to use it to enroll high-paying clients, all of that good stuff. I had no idea. And so I too used it wrong. But ever since things turned around for me, and Instagram has now become one of my favorite platforms for truly growing my business, I've made it a mission to teach everything that I know about Instagram on this channel. So do me a favor and subscribe to this channel, and of course like this video, and of course go ahead and share this video so that other people like you who are also using Instagram but probably aren't getting any results can get hold of this content and use it to grow their business. So first of all, Instagram, right? We all know Instagram, it's not new. So I'm not going to give you the stats about Instagram. I think that if you're watching this, then you already know how powerful Instagram is. But chances are that you aren't quite sure how to use Instagram to sell or to enroll clients, to make offers, and to really grow your business. Well, I'm going to be sharing all of my best strategies in this video. So what is the first thing you've got to do in order to make Instagram a very successful sales platform? The first thing you really have to nail on Instagram is your ideal client. Oh my goodness. I've met so many people who have grown thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of followers in their account on Instagram, but they're not making any money. And that is because of this one thing. They were not clear on their ideal clients from the beginning. So what I say to my clients and to anybody who wants to know about Instagram and who wants to learn from me is this: you've got to be absolutely clear on your ideal client. And my number two, which I'm going to be sharing in a moment, you've got to be clear on who your ideal client is before you even begin the journey. It is got to be 100% clear. But if you're watching this and you're thinking, but Pam, I already have thousands of followers and nothing is happening, then what I want you to do is to really do an audit of your followers and try to figure out who in that audience could be an ideal client for you. So for example, you may find that a lot of your followers are women or moms, or a lot of your followers are following you because of a specific thing. It could be because of your fashion, the clothes you wear. It could be because of your personality. It could be because of the type of content you create. It could be because of your dog. I have no idea, but there are so many reasons why people follow you. You have got to find which one it is. And so this is for those who already have a big audience, right? So first you discover why they are following you. Then that leads me to the next thing that I want to share with you. Number two is to be clear on your offer. Yes, you've got to be absolutely clear about your offer, what it is that you want them to buy. So number one and number two are pretty much, let's call them twins, right? You can't have one without the other. Very important to understand who they are and to understand what they want. Now, in order for you to understand who they are and what they want, i.e. the offer that you have created for them or the product that you have created, you've got to first understand their pain point. You've got to understand what it is that's keeping them up at night. You've got to understand what their daily frustrations are. And you've got to answer all of these questions, because it is the answers to those questions that allows you to create a product that they will buy. This is so important. I cannot stress this enough. And in fact, it is for this reason that I have gone ahead and created my ultimate target audience persona, which helps you to really get clarity on who your ideal clients are. I'm going to pop it on the screen, link it below this video, and of course, link it at the top. Whichever way, just make sure you grab a hold of that once you finish watching this video so that you can use that to dive into your ideal clients. Number three for how to sell on Instagram is to gain their trust. Now, You've heard this before. People buy from people who they know, like, and trust. In fact, not only do they have to know, like, and trust you, they've got to love you, right? A lot of people think that their offers or their products, that it's unique. Believe you me, there is nothing new under the sun. So for this reason, you've got to make the extra effort to make sure that you show up for your audience, that you're building that community, your own tribe, your own community. Because then that way, if there's somebody else who has the same product as you, the same offer as you, the same packages as you, or does the same thing as you, even looks like you, right? They will know that that person is not for them. They want you because it is with you that they have created a bond. It is with you that they have fallen in love with and they have, you know, bought into you, right? So how do you gain that trust? You do that by really, really showing up. So you got to show up in your stories. One thing that I do in my stories is I do a lot of lifestyle stuff. So I share a lot about my life. I share a lot about my home, my kids, what I'm up to. I'm not talking business all the time. And in fact, on that note, I invite you to follow me on Instagram and of course check out my stories to see some of the things that I do and how I do it. We'll pop the link for my Instagram right below this video, but right at the top in the top right hand corner you will see my handle for both of my accounts. So go to @PamelaBassa and really check out some of the ways that I use my stories. Even in the midst of my launching, I do an 80-20 rule, which is the Pareto principle, where 80% of the content that I put out, especially on my stories, actually has nothing to do with business. Now, why am I doing that? I'm doing that because I'm trying to develop a community on Instagram, right? I'm trying to grow my audience over there and I want them to know me, like me, and trust me, because I know that without that, they won't be able to buy from me because, you know, why would they? They don't know me, they don't like me, they don't trust me. So it is very important that not only are you showing up for your community, but you're showing up in the right way. So use Instagram stories, use Instagram reels, use IGTV. And of course, that leads me to my next point, which is point number 4, and that is to go live on Instagram. Now, granted, I don't do lives on Instagram as often as I probably should, just to be honest with you, but I can tell you that the times when I do go live on Instagram, I see a massive reach on my account from my lives. And the beautiful thing about these lives is that they can then be turned into IGTV. And of course, you can repurpose these lives into other, you know, other pieces of content. You can cut them up and put them in your stories. You can repurpose them onto Facebook, repurpose them onto LinkedIn. And depending on the quality, you can also repurpose it onto YouTube. So it is incredibly important that you think about, you know, your live stream strategy on Instagram. Now, why should you live stream on Instagram? Well, it's important to live stream on Instagram because it is one of those rare occasions that people will actually have the opportunity to interact with your content in a whole new way. So live content, as you know, is very different, vastly different from pre-recorded content. With pre-recorded content, we know it's pre-recorded. We know that you might answer a question when you're free. Your viewers know that. But when it's live, they know that it is live. And so therefore, the chances of them asking a question is very high because they know that you're going to answer it. And again, it goes back to my previous point about building a community and building that know, like, and trust factor. So live streaming is a very, very important way to do that. I do live streams all the time on Facebook, for example, and I've seen the massive amount of impact that it has had on my business. And so that is another thing that we are also now doing on Instagram. And I want you to do the same. If you want to build that know, like, and trust factor, you've got to be community focused and you've got to be focused on really showing up for your audience. Number 5 is to use direct messaging or the DMs to your advantage. A really good friend of mine a little while back, you know, said to me, Pam, she logged into my Instagram, we were looking at it together, and she saw so many unopened messages. She said, Pam, why aren't you opening your messages? I was very busy at that time and I had so many DMs coming to me because I was utilizing all of these strategies to the point that I couldn't even handle my DMs because it was blowing up. I had to, you know, invite a whole other team members and hire people to really help me to manage my DMs. Now, what is the point that I'm making? You've got to utilize your DMs. Oh my goodness. The DMs is where people are going to reach out to you when they are truly interested. Yes, you are going to also receive a lot of spam in the DMs, but I promise you, there is a piece of diamond in the rough right there in your DMs. So utilize it. One of the most powerful ways that I utilize my DMs is I link it to my stories. So I try to use a lot of questions in my stories. I do polls in my stories. And then when people respond to those polls, it then gives me the opportunity to DM them because they have responded to a poll. And so Instagram stories and DMs work hand in hand together. When you really think about pairing those two strategies together, it stops you from feeling like, oh, why should I DM people when they haven't reached out to me? And that's another thing that I must say. Please do not wait for people to always reach out to you. They won't, right? Sometimes they're actually a little bit nervous, a little bit scared, or a little bit unsure, right? Perhaps they, you inspire them so much that, you know, they just think, perhaps you don't even have the time to respond to their DMs, etc. So sometimes it's really nice to just be the one who actually reaches out to people, and you will be pleasantly surprised that they will really welcome a private conversation with you. So this is just one of the most effective ways to fill your calendar, especially if you are selling anything high ticket, such as high ticket packages, high ticket services, high ticket coaching. Number six, for how to sell on Instagram. This one is about not selling on Instagram at all, okay? So you've got to understand that social media is about being social, right? So again, it takes me back to that Pareto principle of the 80-20 rule. Now, I do sell on Instagram, but I try to make sure that the times when I'm selling on Instagram where I'm actually making an offer blatantly on my feed, that it's minimal. Like, it's so minimal, it's probably like 10%, not even 20%. You've got to make sure that you are instead bringing people into your world through your content. So you've got to allow your content to do the selling for you. And then, of course, you make sure that whatever it is that you are selling, that you've added the links in your bio, you've added links in your stories, you've added the links, you know, you're creating Instagram Reels, you're using all sorts of multi-format strategies to really reach your ideal clients. So when it comes to selling, you've got to sort of think the opposite. It's to unsell, which is really strange, especially when you're in business. It's like, we're in business to sell, we're in business to do business. But you've got to think about it, that people are not on social media to do business. They're on social media to be social, to meet other people, right? To connect with people. And so you've got to think connection first. Now, what is the next tip? The next tip is one of the most subtle ways to do the selling is to use a freebie. What is a freebie? A freebie is like a lead magnet. That's another thing that you could call it, right? It is something that you give to somebody for free in exchange for their name and their email. Now, why would you want to offer a free thing, a lead magnet, to get people onto your email list? It is because emails are one of the best places to do the selling. So one of the strategies that I highly encourage you to use is to use Instagram as a way of filling your email list, and then, of course, doing the selling in your email. And that leads me to the next tip, and that is to share testimonials and customer success stories. This is so, so, so important. Why? Because this is another way to build trust. Now, one of the ways that we do it is we share our testimonials in our stories, in Reels, in IGTV, on the feed. We're sharing stories and testimonials and client successes absolutely everywhere, on every micro platform on Instagram. And in fact, we go a step further and we place our testimonials on landing pages, on sales pages. Why? Because if you have worked hard for your client, you want to shout through the rooftops about it. Now, how do you get these testimonials? Well, you've got to ask your clients, right? When people send you little notes, you know, via the DMs or via emails, you know, thanking you for your services or for your products, or saying how you have transformed their lives, get a screenshot of that, just like this. So get a screenshot and feel free to share these screenshots. Now, one of the things we do is that we often blur the names of the people who have shared these screenshots, you know, to protect them. But you can share these testimonials. And if you don't want to blur the name, then make sure you get their permission. Another thing to do is to get video testimonials. Create case studies. Oh my goodness. Case studies have blown up my business, have grown my business massively. So it's so important that you get used to sharing your client successes, your customer success stories, case studies, and all of these good things, because it really, really develops that trust between you and your audience. The next next strategy that I want to share with you is to make sure that if you are going to be using Instagram stories, that you are using questions. Now, why is it important to use questions? I use questions a lot and I use polls a lot. In fact, I might actually prefer polls more than questions, and I tell you why. It's because polls are very easy. Polls are very, very easy to use because, you know, all somebody has to do is just click on one thing to, you know, to respond to the poll. Questions are also really powerful. The reason why questions are powerful is because when people answer the questions, it goes straight to your DMs. And that, you know, that, you know, reminds me of the strategy that I shared earlier about utilizing your DMs. So using polls and using questions, you know, in terms of that sticker in your Instagram stories is so, so, so important because it allows you to, again, develop that trust, develop that community, develop that relationship. But not only that, it gives the Instagram algorithms a big, massive boost because it shows that people actually care about your content because they are not only looking at it, they are actually responding. So the algorithms will favor you and show your stories to even more people. Go ahead and use questions and polls a little bit more. The next strategy that I want to share with you is to use Instagram carousels or Instagram stories to share tutorials for how to use your product, your offer, or how to access your package, or even how to access a purchase. This is so, so, so powerful. Why? For two reasons. One, it shows off what it is that you actually do, right? It's just advertising your business, but it's doing it in a whole different way. The other thing that it does is that it gives incredible FOMO to people who haven't purchased that product. Oh, imagine that, right? Imagine creating a product and people are watching you use that product or show how to access that product, but they don't have that product. What will it do, right? It will allow them to be curious about how to get that product. So I really love doing this. Just do a screen share, pop it on Instagram, showing how to use a product, and you'll find that you will get more sales of that product, or more people will schedule calls with you. You'll get more inquiries about your services because of this strategy. And finally, 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 my last point in this video, I mean, there are so many ways to use Instagram to sell, but I wanted to give you my best stuff, you know, in this video. I might create another one to give you more stuff, but for now, my final strategy in this on this topic today is to use a pre-launch strategy before you even go into your launch. Yes. Now, you'll notice that a lot of people who really understand social media are doing a lot of pre-launch. Now, what is a pre-launch? A pre-launch is a series of activities or events that you do or that you put together before the main thing. So it's pre-launch. So if your launch is the main thing, the pre-launch is everything that you do before that. Now, how do you do this on Instagram? There are three ways. One, you can do a pre-launch on your Instagram stories. Number two is you can do a pre-launch on your Instagram Reels because of the algorithms. And number three, which is one of my personal favorites, is as part of your pre-launch strategy, you can use giveaways. You see that? These are all really powerful ways to make a lot of noise about your product, about your offer, about your service before you even open the cart. That way, when the cart is opened, people aren't hearing about it for the first time, right? They have already seen the pre-launch event. They have enjoyed your entertaining Instagram Reels. They've been watching your stories, they've participated in your giveaway, they've done a lot of things, you know, to be a part of this. And so because of that, when you actually launch, you'll realize that you have moved them through that customer journey and you have in fact built that know, like, and trust factor just through your pre-launch events. So let me know in the comments below, which of these strategies did you like the most? Will you be using the most? I really love Instagram. It has been massive for my business, and I'm so grateful for the platform, and I keep learning, and for everything that I learn, I will keep bringing to this channel. So if you haven't already subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe. I'm working hard to grow this channel. So subscribe, turn on the bell, so that you, my darling, will be the first to see when we publish new videos, and we publish 3 times a week. So go ahead and do that. Now, before I wrap, comment below and let me know which of these strategies you will be using. And of course, if you want to learn more Instagram strategies, then take a look at this playlist for all things Instagram and how to use it to grow your business, enroll clients, generate sales, and all of that good stuff. I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Bye-bye. Bye.